Hello and welcome to CloudFront's YouTube channel. Today, we'll learn how to customize the new Azure API Management Developer Portal. So let's begin. The Developer Portal is an automatically generated, fully customizable website with the documentation of your APIs. It is where consumers can discover your APIs and learn how to use them, request access, and try them out. Let's see how you can open the developer portal. So I'm in the API management services, and under the API section, you'll get the developer portal option at the top. Just click on it to open the developer portal. If you're accessing the developer portal for the first time, the default content is automatically provisioned in the background. The default content has been designed to showcase the portal's capabilities and minimize the customizations needed to personalize your portal. This feature is available in the premium, standard, basic, and developer tiers of API management. One must note that the developer portal is now deprecated and it will be receiving the security updates only. You can continue to use the old developer portal in the developer portal section, and in the portal overview you will get the deprecated developer portal option from where you can use it, but this feature is available only until October 2023 when it will be removed from all API management services. So let's see how you can customize the new Azure developer portal. Now, to get a feel of how your website is gonna look, you can just copy this URL and open it in a new incognito tab. So, over here you have the APIs section from where you can request your APIs. You can simply click on any of the API that you want to try out. You also get the API definitions in YML, JSON, WDL. Click on try to test the API. Enter your subscription key. Enter the message and click on send. Get a response. So it's an easy way to test your APIs from this developer portal. The developer portal can be customized and styled through the built-in drag and drop visual editor. If you need to extend the custom logic, which isn't supported out of box, you can modify its code base. The portal's code base is provided in the video's description. For example, you can implement a new widget which integrates with the third-party support system. You can customize the developer portal with this visual editor. On the left menu, you can get the options to edit the pages, the media, the layouts, the navigation. There are system settings. You can choose the different styles. Also, you get the option to publish the website, and also a help section is provided. At the bottom, you get an option to switch between different ports, such as the large screen, a mobile screen, medium screen, etc. You can also choose the website's content is available to anonymous or authenticated users. You can click on save option to save the changes. You can undo your changes or redo them as required. Now let's go back to the home page. And you can also add new sections by clicking on this plus button, which is provided in blue color. You can add the sections as required. Some default styles are provided to help you. Also, by clicking on the gray plus icon, you can add different widgets such as buttons, testimonials, menu, etc. You can start the customizations from the home page, wherein You can edit the logo to match the logo of your organization. Let's say I have a logo already uploaded in the media, but if you don't have that, you can upload the your logo from this particular button. So you can also change the height and width of the logo. You can keep the entire sections which are provided by default, or if you don't require them, you can remove these sections. So if I don't require this section, I can simply delete it. You can also change the content within this, or you can simply, let's say, welcome to .xyz. You can also move these sections by simply dragging and dropping them. Remember, after you make the changes, to hit the save button, which will save your changes. And once it's done, you can simply go back to the incognito tab and hit the URL again to see the changes. Remember, if the changes are not being reflected, you can publish your website using the operations and hitting publish website. Alternatively, you can also do it from the Azure portal, wherein under the developer portal, go to portal overview and hit publish and refresh in the incognito window. It might take some time to reflect the changes, or you can clear the cache and check once again, or check in a different browser altogether. Now, you might also select the styles if you're not happy with the default fonts, and if you want the color scheme to match your branding, you can choose it from here. Remember that the portal needs to be republished after API management service configuration changes. For example, republish the portal after assigning a custom domain, updating identity providers, setting delegation or specifying sign-in and product terms. To let visitors of your portal test the APIs through built-in interactive console, enable the CORS cross-origin resource sharing on your APIs from here. You can apply it at the global level as well. A link on how to apply the CORS policy is provided in the description. Now you can start experimenting with the Azure Developer Portal and start customizing as per your needs. Thank you for watching the video.